Let's recap those headlines for you this hour. Libya's rival political factions have reportedly agreed to hold presidential elections by February 2018. This follows a meeting between Libyan army commander Khalifa Haftar and the head of the country's government of national accord, Fayez Sarraj. A spokesperson for the Egyptian armed forces said, following negotiations, both Khalifa Haftar and Sarraj agreed to adopt a statement, including the plans to hold elections in 2018, among other provisions. Police in the DR Congo have raided a separatist group in the capital, Kinshasa, killing at least four people. Dozens of armed police stormed the home of Ne Muanda Nsemi, a member of parliament and leader of the Bundu, DR Congo, a religious cult. The leader of the group, a self-styled prophet, however, escaped the raid. The group is seeking to revive the pre-colonial Congo kingdom that flourished for centuries around the mouth of the Congo River. And in Kenya, a Kenyan court of appeal has ordered the release of seven medical doctors union officials who had been sentenced to 1 month in jail. The officials have been set free pending a hearing and determination of their appeal. Officials from the Kenya Medical Practitioners, Pharmacists and Dentists Union were jailed on Monday for contempt of court after they refused to call off the public hospital strike, which has entered its third month. Negotiations will resume on Monday. And India has successfully launched 104 satellites in a single mission from the space port of Sriharikota in the southern state of Andhra Pradesh. This is a world record of launching the most satellites at one go. The Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle carries a 700 kilogram main satellite for Earth observation and 103 smaller nano satellites, which weigh a combined 660 kilograms. Nearly all the nano satellites are from other countries. And that's a look at your headlines.